All right. Hey, good morning. All right. Good morning. Woo! Oh, man. On the count of three, let me really hear you. One, two, three. Woo! All right. We woke the neighbors up today with our sound checks and our band practices. So we're expecting to hear something this week from them. But it's great to have you here today. Let me make a couple announcements that we need to get out just in case you missed it. There's a restroom this side of the building under the carport to your right. This carport into the foyer to your right. So long as you're making right-hand turns, you're headed in the right direction. So if you need to use those, that's where they are. We did place, because we just never missed this one. They're offering boxes. We've been using those since the pandemic, and we were able to open back up because it's touchless service. And so if you need to drop your offering off, there's two there. There's one over here. Use them lots of times, however, but that's where they are. I have two announcements to make that affect, the first one affects the Wadsworth and the Doylestown campus. Both of our campuses start up their youth stuff this week. Both of them? Yeah, a little clapping, all five of you. Come on. You got to give us more energy than this, all right? So they open up. The Wadsworth campus opens up at 6:30 this Wednesday night. And then the Doylestown campus, theirs opens up at 7 o'clock here at the campus. And they're doing a kickoff, a bonfire, and a couple things. So make sure your young people are at that. Don't let them miss out on a single thing. And after we do that, we'll just keep on rolling with the youth department. And then group life, if you've not signed up for group life, there's lots of ways to do that, but the main thing is to do it. We have actual live group life where the group actually meets in person, and then we have Zoom group life. So whichever one you are comfortable with, get signed up. The one thing, like, just don't settle for doing nothing this run. We hope that you'll get involved in that. And we know and we recognize that 2020 has been you will never forget 2020. There's been so many crazy, strange things that have happened in 2020. I want to talk about that for just a second when it comes to church. Like for me, I started wearing these weird shirts, man. We started having weird church, like having chairs spread out. Half the church is watching online. Half the church is in the building. And it just was weird. So I just went out one day. I was in the store and I saw these weird shirts. I said, I'm just going to start wearing weird shirts on Sunday. So I've been wearing them. I was going to stop today. Today was going to be my finish line. Then somebody came up to me and said, hey, we were on vacation. And when we saw that shirt, it had Jerry written all over it. So I'm going to go one more. I'm going to go one more week, so I have that one on next week. But it has been weird. And, you know, I started doing this because, like, you can either... Oh, we have Vanna up here, all right? And those of you that are young, you can Google that. It's Vanna White, all right? You're probably like, Vanna, who? And so I know it's been weird, but here's some things I want you to remember. That even in during weird, crazy times, God is still working. And I think all of us would recognize that God was doing something during this whole thing. I think some of the things that God was doing, for one, he was refining us. And that always happens. Anytime there's a shift in what we are used to, God does something with it and he refines us. I remember being on the couch at our home in the evening, hearing them giving reports about their predictions of what might happen. And I remember that night thinking, oh my gosh, man, it was just like it just struck me. And right there I was thinking, you know what, man, that kind of scared me a little bit. Then I started thinking, you know what, I'm not going to live in that world. And God started to take that moment, refine me a little more too, and develop my faith. And I got a chance to push back worry. And I think some of you in here too, you've had some shifts in your life during this. God uses those to refine our faith, and so that's important for us. God uses these times to remind us. I think all of us, and I had people come up to me, people who just don't like people, like they would openly admit, I don't really like people. How many of you out there, you just don't like people? Raise your hand. Okay? Well, we don't like you either, okay? Just want you to know that, that kind of goes both ways. But, you know, some people are just not like people for people, you know? And they came up to me and they said, Jerry, if there's one thing I've figured out and God has reminded me, that we all need community, that every one of us need community. We need God in our life and we need other people in our life. And so here today, we've decided to come outside with this thing. Why? So we can draw the community, the church that's now under the umbrella and is called Crossroads. But the greater picture is that we are part of the church that's being built by God. And so we're all, you know, through this journey, we're just reminded that community is important. And don't let that get away when this thing's over. We need each other. We need the church. And let's not give up on it. God also, and during this time, he reminds us that God restores. Now, the church is going to come back a lot different. We've already, in our leadership, we've already recognized that. And the churches across America know that, you know, it's going to come back a little differently. It's going to come back a little slower. People are just going to be, you know, just a little more uncomfortable with close community and all the different things that are going on. But the bigger picture is, and the church has been affected through this, but don't you doubt that the church belongs to God. God builds the church, and he's going to restore the church, and he's going to restore it to a greater point. And I believe that, I believe the Crossroads is going to be greater on the other side of this than it was going into it. And so when you look at 2020, don't you throw it away and say nothing good happened in it. That God was refining us. God was reminding us. God was restoring us. And through this whole thing, I think every one of us are reminded how important it is for us to find things to rejoice about. And so we hope that you've come here today ready to rejoice and ready to engage in the worship and engage in the community, engage in that we, you know, we are the body, and we are the body under Christ, and we will celebrate what God has done in us, which is greater than any negative thing that has happened in 2020. So today, I hope that you'll really connect with it and really rejoice. We have so much to still rejoice about. I know 2020 is crazy, but my list of blessings and good things and things to rejoice about are longer than my negative list. And so today we come here to rejoice. And one of the things that we have to rejoice about is that we have the resurrection in front of us. Man, I hope you connect with that. That I know we're walking around here and we're alive and all that kind of stuff. But we have hope beyond this life. And we hold on to it. And it empowers us to think that the grave has no hold on us. To think that this world has no hold on us. That I've been completely and totally disconnected from this world. I don't belong to this world. I belong to God. And I have the power of the resurrection of Jesus Christ living in me. And I have that to look forward to. And I have that to worship God for. And I have that to celebrate for. And I hope here today that you are like me, that you celebrate the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And if you've come in here today and you're kind of disconnected from that, I would pray today that you would connect with that. That maybe through the morning that you would say, you know what, man, I'm just not quite connecting with that. Man, come see us. Come look for the weird guy in the weird shirt. And I would love to talk to you about it. But today, let's rejoice. Man, there's that glorious day, that glorious hope. And it's not manufactured by us. It is given to us as a gift from God. So today, let us rejoice. Let's rejoice in the power of God. So let's stand up. I'm going to have prayer. And we're rolling. If your neighbor needs help getting up, you can't help them. We're in a pandemic, all right? You stay away from them. They might punch you. All right, Father, today, thank you that we can be here. We are ready to worship. We are ready to rejoice, Father. We are ready to be reminded that you are the one and only God. There is none more powerful. There is none greater. And salvation is only found in Jesus Christ. And so today, we as the body of Christ come to declare that God, you are King of Kings It's in Christ's name I pray. Amen.
Serve an awesome, awesome God. He will save us. He will resurrect us in the final day. We'll be with him forever. It'll be an awesome and incredible thing. And God is the one who makes the way for us. There is no other way. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. He is the only way. And that's what this song is about. That Jesus is the way maker. Some of you may today be saying, you're going, I don't know. I don't see much going on. And that's one of the things I love. One of the parts in this song that I love. It says, even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're still working. Isn't that true? Sometimes you don't feel like, I just don't feel like God's anywhere. But I'm telling you right now, he is there, and he is still working in your life. Let's sing this together. Still have to do some things to get to heaven. He paid it all. He didn't leave. leave some of it to us so that we would be always wondering, or we would always be worried whether we've done enough or we haven't done enough or what's happened. But Jesus paid it all. For that, we give him so much thanks and so much praise. the rest of the season.
All right, church. Let's keep that praise going. Come on, church. I'm going to use this one. Here we go. Can you hear me now? All right. Let's keep that praise going. Anybody out there thankful this morning that it doesn't rely on you, that Jesus paid everything so that you didn't have to pay for it yourself? That's the reason why we're here this morning. And we're going to take a couple of minutes right now, and we're going to be thanking God today. Part of this service is to praise Him for the ministry that He's been doing, not just here in Doylestown for many, many years as Crossroads has been here ministering to people, but now is in Wadsworth doing ministry for years now. And we're celebrating 1 year of doing ministry in Oroville as a campus coming up very soon. And so in that...
Check, there we go. All right, they got me once I can be free. All right, so when we talk about this idea of celebrating 1 year of ministry, when we look back on what's happened in Oroville over the past year, I want to bring words of encouragement to you as a church today, because it's through you, the multi-campus, not just through our single campus of Crossroads, that ministry is being done in Oroville. It's through your support, what you gave to help get our campus started. It's been through your prayers, your uplifting words. It has been through your generous donations to different things that we've done that we are able to stand here today and say we have been able to do a great, great year worth of ministry. And even despite COVID, like, let's just, COVID, get on out of here. When it comes to spreading the gospel, it holds no power over what we do as a church. And so we're thankful today to be able to celebrate a year. We're coming up on an opportunity where we're going to have our first baptism as a campus is coming up in just a couple of weeks. We're excited to be able to do it. Yeah, that's worth celebrating. People declaring that they've given their lives to Christ is worth celebrating for us. And so what we want to say this morning, what I want to declare is just this. There is a singular reason why we're able to celebrate this year anniversary for Oroville. There's a singular reason why we get to continue to do ministry, and it is because of Jesus and Jesus Christ alone. That's what we stand on. And so because of Jesus Christ, what we're going to look at in this next song that our band is going to come and lead us in, it's called King of Kings. And what I want to do is just take a minute to break down just a couple of lines from this song and to talk about what it should mean to us as one large church body, three different campuses gathered together today. This song is going to get to a point, and I want to say this, the whole song is about the gospel of Jesus. As you listen to the words of the song, what you're going to hear is, from the very beginning, our need for the gospel. You're going to hear how the gospel played out through what Christ did on our behalf. And then you're going to hear the results of the gospel and where it leads us to today. And so that's what I want to talk about, is from this line. It starts off and it says, and the church of Christ was born. Hey, that's us, church. We were born the day that Christ rose from the grave. He gave life to us. He said, then the Spirit lit the flame. Are you thankful for the Holy Spirit's work in your life? I know that I am. He says, now this gospel truth of old shall not kneel, shall not faint. That's where we are right now, right? This world is falling apart. Lots of craziness going on. Lots of different things trying to stop us from meeting together, from spreading the gospel as a church. But we have the promise in Scripture that the work of the Lord will not be deterred. It will not be stopped. That nothing can stay the hand of God as He continues to move on the face of this earth. And so that means that the truth of the gospel is not going to flex for any man's opinion. It's not going to flex for anything that happens in this world. No circumstance can stop the gospel from spreading to the people on the face of this planet. And nothing's going to stop God from doing that. And that's the confidence that we live in sharing this gospel. It's the confidence that took us to go and plant another church in Oroville, to plant a church in Wadsworth, and God willing to plant more churches out in the future into different areas so that we can continue to take the message of the gospel with us. And this song's going to continue on, and it's going to say, it continues this, it says, by His blood, in His name, in His freedom, I am free. Amen. And he continues on. He says, for the love of Jesus Christ, who has resurrected me. And what I want to say this morning, church, is this is not just simply a service where we get to come out and hear our favorite worship songs. We're definitely doing that. I hope you've been singing as loud as I have. I won't have any voice left by the end of this thing, because I'm just belting it out back there. And you need to be thankful that I'm not mic'd for most of that, okay? But we're here to sing these praises. We're here to lift them up, not just so we can sing our favorite songs, but today, so that as a church, we can join together and bring glory to the name of Christ, because He is infinitely worth every moment that we can give to Him today. Amen. So that's what we're here to do. That's what we're here to lift up. And so I want to just leave this off by praying over us as three campuses together this morning. I'm going to hand it off to our band to lead us in some great worship. And I hope that in the midst of all this today, the goal is not to make you feel warm and fuzzy. The goal is not to make you feel like, oh man, I'm glad I went out today to hear my favorite worship songs from the band at my campus or anything along those lines. I hope that you leave here today with your heart a little more in tune to Christ. I hope that you leave here today ready to worship and uplift His name even more than you ever have in your life. Because today and every day, since the day that Christ came into our lives and since the day till the day that He calls us home, He is infinitely worthy of our praise. So let's worship Him today. I'll pray and then we'll leave. Heavenly Father, we thank You again for this opportunity to be out here today. Father, I thank You that we can sit here as multiple campuses together on these soccer fields, that we can see the impact that Your gospel has made here in this area through these churches that You have planted in these various communities. Father, I pray for every single person that's sitting out here right now, whether there be somebody here who maybe doesn't know You yet as their Savior, that Father, You would draw them into You, that they would see today the love of Your family, the love that You have granted to us, and that even through this song and the last song that we sang, that they would recognize that You paid everything to purchase them back from sin and death. Father, I pray that as three campuses gather together today, that we would worship and lift Your name in a way that is pleasing to You, God, that it would be a sweet, sweet sacrifice on our behalf to You today, and that You would be given all the glory for everything that happens in this place and at every single one of our campuses out into the future. Jesus, we love You today more than we can express, and we hope that these songs will do a sufficient job today of bringing our glory and praise to Your ears. We love You. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's stand and worship together, church.
Church of Christ was born in the Spirit, in the flesh. everyone. Yeah. That's awesome. This next song we're going to sing, I know Orville knows it really well, but it echoes the verse in the Bible that I'm sure most of you guys are familiar with. So I just want us to say it together. It's John 3:16. You guys know it. So let's hear it. A shout to the testimony that Christ has given us by the fact that our names are registered in heaven. If we believe in him, that means that one day we get to do this for all of eternity. That is super exciting. All right, let's get those hands up.
Can't get over. My name is registered in heaven.
Testimonies. Let's give the Orville band a hand.
That was awesome. So,
you guys can have a seat. If we haven't met yet, my name is Edward, and I'm the campus pastor of our Wadsworth campus. And so it's just great to be out here together, praising God together of all three campuses. And a part of what we're celebrating, as Josh mentioned, this morning is the birthday of the Wadsworth campus. So on this Sunday, 5 years ago, on this Sunday, 5 years ago, we had our very first service in downtown Wadsworth. And ever since then, we just want to praise God and thank God that we've had 5 years of people hearing the amazing good news of Jesus. 5 years of people responding to the amazing good news of Jesus. 5 years of people being baptized. 5 years of kids coming in on Sunday and having their mind and their view of God shaped by the Word of God. We've had 5 years of groups meeting together and praying for one another and supporting one another and challenging one another to go out and to live like Christ. And we've had 5 years of people singing in downtown Wadsworth, praises to God, the one who deserves all of our praise. And so glory to God for that. Praise God for that. And like Josh said, thank you. Maybe you're part of one of the other campuses and you remember when Wadsworth was planted and you gave towards it and you worked towards it and you prayed for it. And then you maybe moved on with your life. Well, it's been going on for 5 years now. Now there's a church where there wasn't a church before. And that is an awesome thing. And I'm thankful that a year and a half ago, I got to become the pastor over there. And that earlier this year, we were able to hire Timmy on full time. And we're just continuing to move forward. And we don't know what's next. We don't know what God has for us next because nobody does. But based on what he's done in the past, we're excited. We're excited about what he's doing. And so praise God one more time for 5 years over in Wadsworth. And now as we move on to the Wadsworth band, I just want to remind us again who we're worshiping this morning. The Bible starts out, in the beginning, God. That God was there but before there was anything else, before there was anything we see, before that there was the universe that we occupy, God was there in eternity past, existing in perfect unity, in perfect joy, in perfect love, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And he didn't need anybody. He didn't need anything. And yet he created everything we see. I love worshiping outside. We get to look up at the clouds and the sky that God made. Our feet are on the ground that God made. That he made all of this. And how did he do it? He spoke it into existence. Everything we see and everyone we've seen, he spoke that into existence. That is the power of the word of God. Ezekiel, an Old Testament prophet, he had a vision from the Lord, and he wrote about it in Ezekiel. And he had this vision. And in this vision, God took him to a valley. And in this valley were just dry bones everywhere. There was just death everywhere, bones everywhere, bones so old and so dead that they were dry. And God asks Ezekiel a question. He says, can these bones live? What would you say? I have no idea what I would say. Ezekiel didn't know either. So he said, Lord, only you know if these bones can live. And the Lord told, Ezekiel's a prophet. He told him to prophesy to these bones. He told him, say to these bones, dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. And so he starts doing that. And as he does that, he hears a sound. Here's the sound of dry bones rattling as they come together and they form an army for God's people where there was not one before. From a valley of death, God creates life by the word of his mouth. And he creates an army for Israel. That's the power of the word of the Lord. Jesus would go on to be the word made flesh, and he would testify to this power. He would speak and demons would flee. He would speak and bread would multiply. That when his friend Lazarus died, and all of Lazarus's friends and family were outside of the tomb, and Jesus was outside of the tomb, Lazarus had been dead for days, and nobody asked that question. Nobody asked, can these bones live? But if they had, they would have gotten their answer. Because at the voice of our Savior, he called Lazarus back from the grave, back out from death, and he lived again. That is the power of the word of the Lord. And then Jesus would go on and lay down his life for us on the cross. That because of the cross and because of the overwhelming, crushing wrath of God on him for our behalf, he laid down his life on the cross. And they took him, and they took his bones, and they put it in a tomb. But what happened? 3 days later, God raised Jesus from the grave. He came back to life, and in his coming back to life, he vindicated himself as the Son of God. He proved that the wrath of God had been satisfied, and he answered the question once and for all, can these bones live? Yes. Because Jesus has risen from the grave, these bones can live. I mean, maybe you're asking a question this morning, a dry bones kind of question you're asking this morning. You're asking, can I get through this? Can I go on? Can my marriage be restored? Can I go forward even though I've lost this loved one? Can these bones live? And most importantly, will I, when I take my last breath in this life, will I live again? Jesus answered that question at the resurrection with a yes with his resurrection. And that is the power of the word of the Lord. It has creative power. It has life-giving power. And that's what we believe this morning. So let's stand back up and finish this morning praising the God who has that power.
God is able. Because my God is able to save and deliver and heal and restore anything that he wants to. Just ask him.
So this next song we're going to play is one I'm pretty confident everybody's going to know. This is from way back in the first days that I even was in church. I've been in church my entire life. This song's Holy, Holy, Holy. And I just wanted to take a minute out of this morning and just sing holy to our God. Sing holy, 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 holy.
Together, but what I'd like to do for this last song is invite all the worship bands. You've been asking us for this for a long time. We're going to do it. So singers, come on up here. If you play an instrument and you want to just sing with us as a show of unity, that'd be great too. Come on up. Come on up, everybody. And we're just going to sing this last song. Watch what's going to lead it, but we're going to join in them with us as a great choir. It's going to be a lot of fun together. God can change. He can change your world. He can turn bad things into good things. Only our God can do that.
But it couldn't fill me.
But then Jesus, but then you came along.
Better than him. Let me hear you. Awesome. What a great way to finish. finish up our day. Let's give all three bands a clap. Let's go, man. I appreciate all they do. I appreciate Josh and Edward's leadership at our campuses. Let's give them a hand. I really appreciate that. And I just want to remind you that our very best years are in front of us. They're not behind us. And we're going to live that way, and we're going to move forward that way. That we are three locations, but one heart, one church, one mission. And that's why we've gathered here today, to celebrate the fact that we are one church with one mission under God. And so today, how many of you would like to do this again? Yeah, well, we'll start looking at the calendar, see if we can make it work. I think we've had a great time here today. I appreciate every one of you. In just a few minutes, I'm going to close this in prayer. But I really do appreciate the five-year journey that we've had in Wadsworth. That's amazing. Most startups don't make it. And Wadsworth is thriving. And I can't wait till we get on the other side of this pandemic, and you'll really see it. And the same thing in Orrville. When we get on the other side of this pandemic, you're going to see those campuses rolling again. And so we thank God for that, that soon Orrville will be celebrating 1 year. Wadsworth today, 5 years. And Crossroads, Doylestown, you're going to have to wait about 2 years, and we're going to celebrate 25 years, something like that. And so you'll see Mike with a walker. But we'll get him up here, all right? We'll build him a little ramp, and we'll get him up here. But thanks for being here. Hey, before we go, this is so stinking corny, but I feel like doing it. I'm even going to take my shades off for this one. On the count of three, I want all of you to shout, praise the Lord, okay? Not until I get to three. One, two, three. Praise the Lord! All right, let's do it again. One, two, three. Praise the Lord! All right, that is awesome, man. You're like a little military out there, ready to go. But again, thank you for being here. Let me pray over you. And then when I get done praying, you're going to do, this is how we greet people now. You're just going to turn around and wave. Don't get in their airspace, but you can wave your hand at them. Father, today, thank you that we can be here. Father, we are so, so, so grateful for your work in all of our individual lives. And Father, then you took that and you weaved all of our lives together. You took personalities that would normally not be able to work together. You took all the different backgrounds of our lives and you've weaved them together. And it's called the church. And Father, we get to be the church. We get to be your people marching forward. And Father, we want to help other people be set free in Jesus. And Father, we look out into the future and we know with expectation that one day we will be set free from the grave, from the pain of this earth. But Father, until that day comes, may we wave your banner high. May we wave it with enthusiasm. May we be people who are proud to be called followers of Christ. And it's in his name I pray. And all God's people said, amen. Amen. All right, turn around and wave to somebody. God bless you. Take your trash to the trash can. See y'all.